Pasha, you had the power to freeze time, said my best friend. I was catching up with her at her parents' place when she was here on a 4-day holiday. She says, I'm so thankful and grateful to have gotten a 4-day extra holiday this year. She was teary at this point. A very good evening, Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters and guests. If you're wondering why my friend wasn't yours, this is the reason. If she has to visit her parents, she has to get requisite gate passes from everyone who has an in-law suffixed in relation to her. I could see the pain in her eyes. The pain of being deprived of the basic rights, the right to be her daughter. How many of you here feel that this is a problem that some women face? And why do I feel that most of them would prefer to do nothing? If a boy's upbringing is no different to the girl's, if the boy's parents did not make any less sacrifices and the girl's parents made any more, why do girls need permission to visit their parents? This, according to me, is a basic sense of gender discrimination. We see gender discrimination around us in many ways and many forms in everyday life. The first place that I see gender discrimination is the place we all call home. It is an unwritten law in our country that the girl moves to the boy's house when she gets married. Why is it so? What is the logic behind this? Why should it be the girl who always sacrifices her environment, her home, her friend circle, and many more, mostly? Shouldn't this decision be a mutual decision between the couple who decide to get married and build a home together? Neither side of the parents should intervene is what I strongly believe. Pratima, she is born and brought up in Chennai. She is working in Chennai airport currently and working her way up towards becoming a pilot. Karthik, a typical Bangalore boy, of course, a software engineer. He has a few years of work experience and has recently joined a startup, which he calls his dream job. Prarthana and Karthik met on a matrimonial website first. Karthik visited Prarthana in Chennai, and Prarthana was in Bangalore recently to meet Karthik and his family. The young couple have expressed their decision to get married and lead a life together and build a home together. But what is still not decided is where. Will Prarthana relocate to Bangalore? Will Karthik give up his dream job and move to Chennai? Will Prarthana, if she relocates to Bangalore, be able to travel from Jayanagar to Bangalore airport every day? Are the couple willing to buy an apartment closer to Bangalore airport? And then, will Karthik be willing to travel 10 times more than what he is currently doing? These are the list of questions the two sets of parents ask the couple. I was an audience in that room that day and I was pleasantly surprised by the attitude of the parents. The entire decision now lies between what Prarthana and Karthik choose to do. Home is what you build together, not an exchange offer in marriage. The second place where I've seen gender discrimination is in our own names. I was asked when I got married if I would change my last name. My reply was, my name is mine just as yours is yours. Not that my husband has got an unpronounceable last name, his last name is Srinivasan. There have been many instances where I've been questioned if I'm married to my husband. The most recent one was in 2016 when we checked into a reputed hotel in Delhi. I was asked with raised eyebrows, of course, why I don't have the same last name as my husband. My reply was because I choose not to. This stunned the man manning the desk. He apologized for it later. Surname. Surname is the identity of every family. The family that gives us birth, that builds our value systems, that defines our identity. Why do we have to lose this identity to form another identity? My friends from primary school were able to track me down and invite me for a 25th school reunion. Nobody knew how each other looked. They were able to track me down on Facebook, mostly because I hadn't changed my last name. It was a hilarious game that night when we had a list of names to match with people present in the room. None of us will forget that. Surname, again, is your identity, not an exchange offer in marriage. Customs and traditions. What are customs and traditions? These are just rules and conditions set by society. People set these rules convenient to suit their own ideologies. Whether a girl moves to a boy's house, whether a boy moves to a girl's house, whether a girl changes her last name after marriage, these are all rules set by society to suit their own ideologies. And generations follow them blindly. Set a trend, be a difference, start a new custom and do justice to yourself. Because sometimes you make the right decision, and sometimes the decisions are made right. The choice is entirely yours. Over to you, Mr. President.